shadow of pain and destruction is covering the land. But the light of love within keeps my path lit and the mission strong. And the mission strong. It is a mission to serve, a mission to reach out a hand of hope to another in need. The world presents the problems, but we have the solution to offer. In order to make an impact, we will have to band together in like mind and in love, breaking down the walls of fear that have consumed us. The choice is ours.
Hello, my name is Pastor Teresa Jordan. Everybody calls me Pastor T, so we deem it affectionately known as Pastor T. I am the founder and event coordinator for the REACH Project. And right now I would like to share a little bit with you on what the REACH Project is all about. The REACH Project is a global independent gospel artist movement that is globally evangelizing and bringing hope to distressful situations. And when I say distressful situations, I mean things like global disasters, tsunamis, earthquakes, fires, floods, things of that nature.
True Witness came to know about the REACH Project when we first moved here from New York. We moved to the Atlanta area. It was last March, I think, of 2011. And Pastor T was over with Pastor PJ, and we were just talking about being the storm and what it meant to be the storm. Because everybody wants to dance in the storm, but to really combat what the world has brought, so much apathy and everything to this world, you have to be the storm. You have to rip through and be the storm of love.
When Pastor T first came to me with the idea of the REACH Project and the REACH song, we had an idea to market the song on a global level through social media and our marketing platforms. So what we did was we put together a press release. We talked about the artists coming from all over the world to assemble together in Atlanta to do the project. We put together our press kit and we sent it out over and over to different media outlets. By the time the REACH song was produced and actually came out in February of this year, we had over 100,000 hits on our press kit.
And what our mission is, with one song, one voice, one heart, and one mission, we want to go into the communities as an interim before our government officials maybe have an opportunity to get involved in what has taken place. We want to have an interim startup group or a group of people in the areas that can bring aid and financial assistance to the area immediately.
Well, the REACH Project for us was pretty much the standard mission, one voice, one song, to make a stand to help our brothers and sisters in need. We actually thought about the video from back in the 80s, We Are the World, and we saw how big a change and big a factor that was in all across the world. So we wanted to take that same kind of effort and pride and put into this video.
I've just returned from some international travels. I spent 6.5 months in East Africa, and I had the awesome privilege to meet other REACH ambassadors from around the world. And I'm telling you, the movement, the song, the heartbeat, the mission, it is moving in full effect.
Hey there, cheering, how you is? This here is your favorite right auntie, your Aunt Mabel. Yes, indeed. And cheering, I is sure is glad to be a part of the most, I call it the most fantastic thing in the whole wide world, the REACH Project. Yes!
What the REACH Project means to me is hopelessness, having hope again, and brokenness being healed, and tragedies being restored, and people coming together, and nations coming together, regardless of all the differences, all the races, religions, ethnic backgrounds, cultures, financial things, what all that stuff gets put aside, and you're all coming together saying reach out. And what that means to me also is it's something that we just don't want to say in life. It's something that we want to live in life, and we can only reach out as far as we're willing to get up and get out of a chair and go do it.
If you listen to the words, you listen to the lyrics, you listen to the music, it compels you, it draws you in.
Just being able to connect with God's people and express His love, you know, and it's what we've been called to do. We've been called to go out and to bring in the people to win souls.
I think that the Reach Project is a right now project. It is on time. It is anointed and appointed for today. We have natural disasters coming at us, it seems like, on a weekly basis now.
The sky was blue and the sun was shining and the birds were chirping when I woke up this morning. But for some, that's not a reality. That's not even a dream. They wake up to tragedy and to survival. Every day is survival. I was able to eat breakfast this morning, and it was easy. But for some, that's not a possibility. It's about survival. And it's because of, if there's a fine line in my world and theirs, a fine line. One storm, one devastating natural event can happen like that, and it can change your life.
What it means to me to reach is basically to love. With the heart of Christ, because if we do that, if we stay in His presence and we allow Him to permeate our hearts, then we can extend our arms, which are His arms, so that we can love, because if we lift Him up, He said in His word that He'll draw all men unto Him. So we just have to keep Him lifted up.
And when you have that love for God, and you see someone else struggling or needing that love for God, that is when you're, you know, that's your cue. That's supposed to be when you are to reach out and help that person and hand that love over and show them the love for God as well.
Yes, Lord. You know what I think about reaching? I want to church somebody. Yeah, I want to church it. Yes, indeed. I mean, we talk about a group of folk, independent folk, coming together, thinking about other people. Ain't that something else? Lord have mercy, made me want to cry.
One of the things that I love so much is that we are able to come together from all genres, all cultures, you know, all backgrounds, to be able to unite in the love and the unity of Jesus Christ and really be the helping hand that reaches out.
If this, for some reason, is the first time you're ever hearing about the Reach Project or the Reach Song or our Reach Ambassadors, I would encourage you to, again, take a listen in depth to the song. Let it get into your spirit, because this song, this movement of independent gospel artists, really cultivates community service.
What I hope to see out of the Reach Project, besides people being helped, because that's really what it's about, you know, you hope, whether it's, if the song has to, or the project itself has to, you know, reach millions to do it, then great. If it reaches 10 and those 10 lives or change, then that's great also, because the first and foremost is that God is glorified, and then people are recognized that it's not just a group of people coming together just to write another song and make a difference that way, but it's about a group of people coming together and showing the world that the love that we have and the hope that we have and the forgiveness that we have and the freedom that we have was given to us by Christ, and we're in return going to go take that to a world.
I live for the glory of God to be revealed, and as I've been moving with the Reach Project, I've seen the glory of God. And God put me in remembrance of the scriptures in Acts chapter 3. When John and Peter came along the man that was lame, who had been begging for alms at the gate, and they told him, silver and gold, we don't have any, but what we have, we're going to give it to you. And they spoke words, and those words moved in that man's life. But not only their words, meaning not only the song, but our action, our mission It's so powerful that they reach out the hand and they literally pick the man up by holding his hand. And that's the revelation that God gave me. We've got to reach.
But reach and the Reach Project is something that was birthed in the heart and in the mind of Pastor Teresa Jordan. It is a song that will reach the nations, that will reach our spirit, that will transcend racial barriers and financial barriers and sects of people, because it is one voice, it's one sound. And I thank God it's one God. But this song, the proceeds from the Reach Project will go to help those who have been, whose lives have been devastated by natural disasters.
The writing of the Reach song, it was very interesting because at that time, Pastor T of the Praise Fest Gospel Network and I were talking about, you know, what songs and, you know, how to proceed with the song. And I actually had a song called Reach that True Witness had written. And I sent that to Pastor T and she worked the lyrics, changed the lyrics and changed it up. And, you know, but using the concept of reach, but making it fit. She put these lyrics to fit the ideas of what we were about to do.
Well, we were very excited when Pastor T from the Praise Fest Gospel Network asked us to help out with the music part of it. And obviously it's an honor to be able to do something like that. So we really just wanted to have an emotion that kind of spoke out kind of in a one voice type nation, regardless of your backgrounds or where you came from or what you look like or anything like that. And we felt that a song that had reach was putting all that stuff aside and being able to come together.
If we come together and really get back to our core values, our family, our communities, and things of that nature, I do believe that the stressful situations that come from natural disasters or any other thing that has caused, you know, a flux in faith in your family can come back together as whole, because it is about community, family, us coming together as a people to be our brother's keeper. I look so forward to the movement as we continue to go all over the world to reach the lost, the hopeless, those that are dying, so that we can present the love of Jesus Christ, not just with words, not just our song, but from within our hearts, so that the mission is real and it's known and it's effective. That's what I'm looking forward to.
We're a rock band, but I think the abilities that God's blessed us with has been able to step out of our box and what he has a rock band and what we normally do. Obviously, his rock song, really a hard rock song, might not have captured what the song was about, but we felt that a group of people, artists, independent artists coming together and singing a song, it kind of really captured that we are the world type movement, where no matter, even though different genres come together, you want to try to capture something that could globally, kind of internationally connect and glue everybody together. That's what it means to me. It's more of just, you know, anybody can sit in a chair and or sit down on and just and say, yeah, reach out, and you know, we're here to help. But it goes so much deeper than that. It takes an action and to have a reaction.
I mean, people can sing all they want about love and reaching out, but without the actions behind it, it's, you know, to have a success of the Reach Project, you need to do more than just singing. It has to be more of people reaching out to one another. Just go up and help another person if you see them struggling, or if they're crossing the street with groceries, just open your hand and just help them.
Then True Witness got involved, and Tim Adams and Tom Bowen started writing the music and putting it all together.
It's day three of the Reach Project, writing the song. Mm-hmm. And what's been going on is we have a pretty good idea. We're not feeling any pressure right now at all, even though we've been told we have to have this done by, what, tomorrow?
Yes.
Okay, and sent off, and sent to...
them.
Whoever them is.
So, like, I think if we...
I still have the orchestra.
All right, well, part let's build the orchestra in a little bit here. We know that you got the concept, at least, to it. You started it right at, what, the end of the spoken word to build mm-hmm. build that up.
So, good. You got thing nice. I would do is put probably an electric guitar or some other rhythm.
You really think electric?
Like, right.
The original concept of the song that was written months ago, we really didn't think it was going to work the way that it went, mainly because the song ended up almost 8 minutes.
Yeah.
We got a lot of lyrics, so we're going to have to try to figure out how to cut this down and keep it in a 4 minute range.
But it had to be something that everybody could sing, perform, spoken word, and rap fluidly and kind of seamlessly in a song, and yet still have an emotion to portray that, you know, what the song's about. So the other way we were doing it kind of was more abstract and didn't really flow as well, and with the length of the song.
We know that there's going to be possibly 100 artists. This is really difficult to write a song like this, but the original concept of the song just wasn't going to work, so we basically took only the reach part out and kept it. The rest we went back and reworked to get it to become a radio-friendly song.
Are we doing it during the rap section?
Well, I think you'll play it from part of the second verse on through.
Second
back
verse.
Back off the rap, and then build it back in the rap.
Well, we want that emotion because people need to realize what this is really about. It's more than a song. It is a moment where we want someone to relate to understanding that people are suffering in disasters, suffering in personal injuries, issues that come from, you know, lack of finances, so many things out there.
And it really speaks to me. The whole song speaks to me. And Tim and Tom just put a powerful beat to it, something that would wake people up. And as the Bible says, wake up, O sleeper, and rise from the dead, you know.
It's not just a song. It's a lot of people coming together, singing maybe one line or maybe even a couple words or doing a section. We're not sure how that's going to go. But they're going to come together, and they need to have that emotion in that moment also, but still be able to give their artist flair based on whatever they need to do.
Like a twang.
All right, well, let's lay it down.
What we're going to do is lay down a demo vocal form and the concept idea, send it off to Pastor T. Pastor T will then either approve it or tell us that we need to do something different. We're hoping for the first one. Yeah. The approval process is always good.
I still think it's probably good. Acoustic?
Acoustic, somewhat.
All right, well, let's go lay it down. We'll call it, we'll fit it all together, and then we'll work through that back half. We got to build somewhere, because we're already, 2 minutes in?
So once we got the drums laid down, then we tried to get Dan to do a bass part.
Hey, Dan!
Okay, he's on around.
When that didn't work, we hired somebody else.
Yeah, we hired a professional.
So, and she is actually graduating fifth grade this week.
Yeah.
What's up, Emily?
Yeah. Emily is awesome. We've been trying to hire her for the band. That's beside the point. Working on the vocals and getting the lyrics to fit and stuff, that's been very creative.
First getting the song to see how that would fit.
Orchestra, right? Hey. The lyrics will fit. They've been working so far.
Yeah.
After the piano, then we went back to the drawing board, basically had Dan redo some tracks on the bass and also put down some electric guitars and acoustic. The dobro was a nice effect for the spoken word. We thought
the dobro made it.
Yeah, the dobro made it with a slide, so it's let's hear it for the dobros in the world. Yeah. Okay. And
all tens of you.
Yeah, there's probably 4 or 5 people that play a dobro in the world.
Dan Adams came in with a rap for the middle of the song, which is amazing and powerful.
We put him in a room and we told him, you will not come out of the room until you write a rap part that is this many measures long. And he looked at us like, you probably are right now.
I need a fruit basket in my trailer.
And then he said, well, how long is that? And we came up with a time limit, and he came out of the room like Iron Man.
Yeah.
And
just without the special.
Yeah, without all the special
money.
And the cool money, yeah.
Now I'm living with disaster. It's coming faster. Got my tears and fears camp. Dude, that was it right there, man. That was the money.
The group channel. Hold on. All right, do it again. Here's
all right. Darn group channels. Don't even know what those are.
All right, we're starting at a couple measures before the rap.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Can I get more reverb in my left ear, please?
Yeah, Tom too.
Okay.
It came and it seems to be fitting, so we have a song.
How do we reach a dying world? A world that's filled with pain and grief. How can a song be used to teach the ones that said could not be reached? How is it possible that we go from day to day? Sun up to sundown, day in and day out, and nothing seems to change. Reach.
I wrote the rap part. I really wanted the rap to kind of be a little different from the rest of the song. I really wanted the rap, and I felt led to write it in the kind of the voice of the victims. You know, those who were suffering through these global devastations, the tsunamis, the earthquakes, and all these different things. So I really wanted the rap to kind of come from that point of view. And I hope that I kind of captured that with what it was. And, you know, praying that God can work through it, because I feel that, you know, it's so easy to talk about the disasters, it's so easy to talk about these things, but we never really stop and think about the people who are actually living through it day by day. And so that's what I really hope to have captured with the rap part.
As a people, as one.
Now, we're in the songwriting process, so the recording, we're not sure how that's going to go down. Choir, we hope. But each individual and what parts they receive, we have no idea. So Pastor T on trying to figure that out.
We've just set it up just in case.
Yeah, but we've done everything that we can to hopefully provide you with a song that's truly from our hearts and in all sincerity. We believe in this project completely.
Reach out. This song, I think, really addresses that. Wake up, oh sleeper, and see what's happening. Because the world is asleep. Wake up and see what the world is in need of.
It's always fun to record. It's always fun to get to be creative and get to try to bring a thought to life and give it somewhat of an appearance.
The night that we all gathered in Atlanta for the what we call the Storm Day, it was absolutely phenomenal.
I had the most incredible time, and it was in September of 2011, and it was a day I'll never forget because all the stars in the sky were just shining. Some were just absolutely brilliant and bright.
We gathered beginning in the very early morning, 9 a.m. actually, and all of the ambassadors from across the nation came together, and a lot of them had never seen each other before. They had only met through social media. So social media has played a huge part in the Reach Project being successful.
I don't know how to describe what happened that day, but it was an amazing amount of love. Our family not bound by blood, but family bound in spirit, and brought together in love of the kingdom and of God. And they all came together, and I met the most incredible people. People I had not known before, but people I will know forever and spend eternity with.
The song is awesome. The Reach song is just so powerful. I remember the night of the recording when we gathered in the church in Georgia, and just to feel the power of God moving in that place and to know that truly this was it. We are becoming the storm.
We were really the instrumental part of the recording and the back end engineering and pretty much producing part of the Reach Project. It was actually very interesting doing a music production with over 100 different artists for this Reach Project. My engineer, Mr. Rock Berry, he looked at me when I brought the project to him, and he was like, "For real?" I was like, "Hey, man, big time. Big time calls for big time players." So he actually did most of the engineering in about 3 weeks, and then we went back and we did a lot of tweaking and re-listening and just trying to get the production to be number one A quality for doing such a nice and positive Reach project.
The recording process that day was fun. It was a long day with that. It was you're bringing a lot of people with a few mics, not knowing how everybody sounded, how everybody was gonna dynamically sing the song.
Pastor T, very instrumental in giving us the opportunity to do that. We really appreciate her for doing that. We had a lot of fun with the True Witness artists in the background, band members, having a good time. The other artists came from various parts of the country. They were very, very nice and very eager to be on this project, so that made it very easy to get a great project out. Shanae St. Louis and Yasmin, she's actually one of our artists from Power Rock. Everybody was just having a great time.
It was a very awesome experience being with people from all over this nation and experiencing the gifts and the talents
that God has placed down on the inside of them, and having the same passion, which is to help someone else. And it was just a bunch of nobodies just trying to tell everybody about somebody who can save anybody.
These people had a heart of love and giving and wanting to reach out to a world in need, to nations across the world. People we don't know, but suffering nonetheless in all parts of the world. And these people all came together to reach nations, and with hope and with love, to reach people, to reach hearts, to reach family that we don't know, but they're still family.
When we all came together, it was like family. It was so beautiful. The spirit in the place was of love and caring and concern for our communities. And all throughout the day, as we rehearsed, as we prepared for the recording, and then we did a mock recording that afternoon, several different times we had to stop the recording, and it was because everybody was emotional. They started to cry, and really it meant something to them to all have come together, never having sung together before, this being their first time, and to hear how beautiful the song had come together and how beautiful the voices blended and the message of hope that Reach has been designed for was coming through.
I definitely saw the example of love in the room that day. I had people coming up for me who I had no idea who they were, never saw a day in my life before, came up, put their arms around me, hugged me, told me they loved me, and to me that was definitely an example of love.
You know, everybody has that same purpose and same mindset and why you're there and what it's about, and it's not about how cool we could have been.
I am glad to be here. I'm glad to be here to reach out and become the storm with everybody that says this is a wonderful and awesome thing. This is beautiful.
I'm very excited. You know, the Reach Project is a great concept. It's about everybody coming together as one body, one voice, one hope, one mind to reach out to people who are in need. And that's what True Witness is all about. And that's really what, as the body of believers, we should all be about. It's not about shining as an artist or shining as an individual, but it's about coming together and actually meeting a need for those who are in need.
Where total strangers came together in his name with one mission, one heart, and it was pure worship. You know, we just enjoyed being in the presence of the Lord with each other, and his train filled the temple, and I will be forever blessed by that.
I was a witness to all of that, and I was a part of all of it. Being on stage with the Reach Project and singing in the choir and the chorus with everyone else and all the other amazing artists that were there around me, I felt like I was in heaven, and there were angels singing all around me. And it was the closest we'll get to heaven on earth, because the angels' voices were just filling up my soul with such great love. And I felt like one of those stars in the sky that was just shining so bright.
As we progressed to that night, oh, it was so phenomenal. And I'm sure as you watch the various clips throughout the video, as well as listen to the song, you would hear the love and the compassion from our Reach ambassadors as they shared during this recording.
And had a purpose. I felt like one of those stars in the sky that wasn't one star, but many stars that came together to make the night sky so beautiful. Because it's not one person that can bring beauty to the world. It's many people coming together with a heart of love. And that's what happened that day. That heart of love burst forth in a sky full of light. So honored and blessed to have been a part of the Reach Project. The Reach Project globally is a new approach to showing the world that they're not alone. If the nation suffers through a tsunami or through an earthquake or whatever the situation, whatever the tragedy, could be through hunger, starvation. This world is in need. This world is suffering. Who's going to do it? That one star can become many. We have to come together. Say, well, we can't change the world. There's just, you know, there's just too much to be done. We can't change the world. We're only one person. I can tell you this right now. Me, individually, I am one person who will stand with that sky full of stars, those people who were there at that Reach Project, and the many more who join us. I will stand there, and I will make the difference with my brothers and sisters, with my family that came out that day, and with the family that joins us along the way.
My innermost heart, that if you listen to the Reach song, that is what you will get from the message in that song. It's about our community core values. Let's come back together and be our brother's keeper. A couple of weeks after that, to leave Georgia and then begin to travel internationally and begin to literally reach out our hands so that we can help those that were in hopeless situations or in despair, it was just awesome.
But you cannot resist, because all of us one day will be looking in a book on a list, and if your name is not on it, doggone it. You done did all, heard all, played all, sang all, but for what if he's not involved? From rapping to mom dancing to singing, even romancing within a marriage, you got to understand that God is the one who carries us all. He is the one who helps us win the brawl. That's why we can call his name. Like my man Time said, he is Father Time. Whenever his word is read, that's the daily bread. Please don't get too filled up in your head.
So I make me think about a story. My good old friend Cabdonia, she went through some things, and Auntie could only help her a little bit. And if we would have had the Reach Project back when she was going through her thing, I believe she would have made it a little better. Things wouldn't have been so hard.
Put together a great mission for the world today. You know, the world right now has been kind of having some ups and downs, and people are in trying times. So right now, everybody needs a good word, a good mission, a good brotherhood. So the Reach Project for us was that step and direction to help out.
He's glorious. He's marvelous. He deserves our praise. Each and every day. Oh, he's glorious. He's glorious. He's marvelous.
Well, what I hope to see out of the Reach Project is it expanding all over the world, and people can share in and see what true love from other people, how people from different cultures can join in and be one person.
Reach, will you trust in him? Will you stand on his word? Will you go home? Will you go home and forget everything you heard? Pastor G, this thing is for real. I don't know what else to say.
So we're not here to change what the government is doing or even outdo the government. We're coming alongside as reinforcement, as an aid to help the government to end or to make better, to cover the wound of the global disaster relief.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, y'all got to come with it better than that. Hallelujah. Oh, I say we are becoming the storm. Glory to God. Do I have any believers in this house on tonight? Oh, come on, y'all. Stand to your feet. What's wrong with y'all? Y'all better give God some glory up in here. Hallelujah.
You better choose. What should I hope? What should I do? So many doctrines. Lord, how do I choose? Oh, help me, God. Please make it clear. I want it to be your voice I hear. Choose ye today.
First thing I would want to say to anybody who has heard about the Reach Project or hasn't even heard about the Reach Project but is out there and is suffering in a nation where they don't have a way to have media explain to them what's going on here in Atlanta, Georgia, actually, I really want to tell them that, you know what? We're here. We're here for you. Hang on.
Let me take you higher, yeah, yeah. Let me take you to another level, the one that you've been waiting for. Don't stay right here, don't just settle for less. Let me show you what I have in store for you. I think you know who I am. I'm the one you need to hold to get to your destiny. I'm J-E-S-U-S, can't you tell I'll never fail? I'm Emmanuel, my word.
We're trying to stir the hearts of the world. We are trying to stir the hearts of mankind to reach a world in need. And we're not going to stop until we have done that. I'm not giving up. I'm going to keep going. And I know Praise Fest Gospel Network. I know PG Network. I know my crew out there, all of them. Everybody out there is going to continue on until we can address your needs. We know you're suffering, and we know that every day is survival. And we know that every day, minute, every second, every moment is so critical.
He cried, help me, nobody heard. No way to turn to, no encourage your word. Bad choices in his life. For another woman, he left his children and wife. Christians talked about him, turned their backs. Lost his job and name. Walked idle in the world. Made a mistake, but forgiveness was a way to be heard. You know, he couldn't hear nobody pray. Although he couldn't hear nobody pray. He couldn't hear nobody pray.
Hallelujah. I'm just glad to be in the presence of God again. And we're here for Reach, and the song says hold on. And so when we reach out, we want to make sure that we hold on and we don't give up. Somebody might, you know, have a need tonight. I know that there are some in here, they have family that's in need, but I'm here to tell you that, you know, God says don't give up, that you can trust him. He'll never let us down. Amen. 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 I'm just here to encourage somebody that may be going through. I want to encourage you and let you know that your help is on the way.
When you're going through, you think that no one cares about you. You long for a friend, someone who will understand.
I would like to bless the Lord for Pastor Teresa Jordan, for the vision and for carrying it out and not letting it die, and to work hard and to pound the pavement and to pull people together like True Witness and like Jay Genesis and all the other ambassadors, so that this project will go global for one cause, and that's to save the people of the world.
You got to understand and make a stance for right. No lying.
The word of God says eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard. You can't even fathom or imagine what God has planned for you. Take me to that place. Some of us wrestling to keep stuff down here. Are you planning on staying down here?
You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You don't wanna do that. You don't wanna do that.
But my involvement is to let y'all know that every now and again, y'all don't know, it don't matter what you're going through, that every now and again, it's all right to laugh for Jesus. Yes, Lord. Because you know the joy of the Lord is your strength. And you know I got a lot of strength because I got a lot of joy.
Here I come to you. Now my life anew. And I want to parade.
I am blessed. And I am praying for each and every one of you who are viewing this out there in the world every day. And I want you to know that I do pray for the world. And I do pray for mankind. I pray for everybody. Whether I know you or not, I'm praying for you. And it is an honor to be in your presence here. And I'm thrilled to ask you to be a part of the Reach Project.
I thank you, Jesus, for loving me. No greater.
For people that haven't seen this or know about the Reach Project, I guess the easiest way I would say it is, if you have ever had your life changed, or if you've ever had something happen and a moment's gone by and you went from a tragedy and you overcame that and you were restored from it, or you grew as a person, or just in general your life was changed by a situation, or if you want to see people, if you want to help people and you have that heart and that desire to see a world change, and you want to see what forgiveness can do and what real love can do, and to watch somebody go from the ground, from up here to down here to back up, just in a matter of just having someone reach out and help them, then I would say this is something you definitely want to do.
Remembering my Lord, your suffering.
I really want to ask all of you, each and every one of you, to search your heart and to contact the Reach Project at www.helpusreach.org. Please, www.helpusreach.org. You can do something. Something. It doesn't matter how small or how big, because God sees it all the same. Some people are able to give a penny, some $1 million. It doesn't really matter what it is. It's all the same. You're reaching. You've got a hand and a heart that is filled up.
Lifting you up with thanks and praise.
If you really want to see the world change, and yeah, it can start with one person. I would definitely get involved and find a way to get involved. Find a way to do something where, like I said, share it with your friends. Tell your friends about this. Tell anybody you know about this, because like I said, brokenness and love and loss don't know an age. They don't know any of that stuff. So I don't care how old you are. I don't care where you've been in the past, but if it's something that you really feel passionate about, or like I said, maybe that's happened to you in the past and you say, you know what, that's happened to me, and thank God somebody was there to extend a hand. I want to be able to now go do that for somebody else. And it's really getting off the seat, getting off your chair, going out there and really doing something in whatever capacity or you feel called or whatever it is that you feel you can do. So I would definitely get involved. It's something that can change a world.
Jesus, how I... I want y'all to do whatever, whatsoever the Lord leads you to do, and just continue to support the Reach Project and all my nieces and nephews from around the world. I love and one of them. Ooh, I see y'all in my spirit, and I want to hug all my nieces and nephews. So cheering, y'all do what y'all got to do. Let the Lord lead you and continue to support all of us. And don't forget now, it's serious. But it's all right to laugh at now again, okay? Auntie love you, bye-bye.
How do we reach a dying world? A world that's filled with pain and grief. How can a song be used to tease the ones they said they could not reach?
How is it possible that we go from day to day? Sundown, day in and day out, and nothing seems to change.
Do the ones that sleeping outdoors, father that's jobless, child that is motherless, the ones that really need home.
A community now in ruin, tornadoes have swept away.
Reaching through the darkness, we grab hold of the light. Releasing pride and Satan's lies, we reach for the Christ. No longer will we look in mirrors with feelings uptight. Instead, we'll see reflections that show projections of higher heights. Time to reach past the mess of hell and the grave.
till we grasp in the hands of the ancient of days. Reach past the color, clothes, denominations, grabbing souls across the globe, every heart, every nation.
Fears can't find my laughter. Aftermath, the hope from this wrath. Will you be the one to help me clear this path? Last, be first, quench this thirst. I'm crying to the heavens, won't you feel this hurt? I'm drowning in the rain, tears in the dirt. I'm dying in the fire, I feel the burn. Who's gonna reach for me? A hand don't need no sympathy. This land cries out in dire need. A stand, someone please set me free. This darkest rages. In my mind, I find time is binding me in cages. Can I find a truth, find a hope that will tame this? Will you show the light, the love, contagious? This earth is shaking now, my life, my home's been taken down, but I breathe for a need, a sacred vow. All is lost, cannot be found. Please find me, reach me, teach me, need me, man, it ain't beneath me. But cease that speech and preach you ain't the walking that you need. In my heart, it is crying, I'm dying to fight all alone. I'm ready to steady my path now and make it home. Will someone step out in faith? Time to show me how. Let's all become the storm and reach. I'm ready now.
Maybe I'm lonely, cause somebody hold me. It feels like I'm falling now, I can't hold my ground. Feels like I'm only trying but slowly. It feels like I'm falling now, I can't hold my ground no more.
Please tell me I'm falling. There is no bottom. They say go to Jesus, I feel fine without him. Like I was the man that was known to move mountains. Brought peace to a storm in the midst of the shouting. Funny when you feel like you are on top. Tell everyone that you free but you not. In the blink of an eye, it's just when your clock stops and you drop to your knees just like you have been shot. God help me, please see you all that I got. Without you I'm nothing, you are my true rock. Are the words that you say when your chains just unlock. Knowing God was the key right from the start. He lifted the standard in front of the blood, knowing that we are all covered by love. Christ ended it all when he shedded his blood, so you don't have to say.
Maybe I'm lonely, can somebody hold me? It feels like I'm falling now, I can't hold my ground. It feels like I'm lonely, trying but slowly. It feels like I'm falling now, I can't hold my ground no more.
No girls, no homies. Looking for the wrong one to hold me. Show me how to be a man. Bullet in my head. I should be dead, trying to chase at the prayer. But instead, I'm laying on the bed. All of a sudden, got God in my head. If it wasn't for him, I'd be blacked out, knocked out in the hearse with the lights out. Now all I can do is.
Thank you.
operate.